coveted jobs at Wimbledon is probably a job you didn't even know existed, which is being a hitting partner, a sparring partner here at the championships. I'm with James and Mike, and you guys, you are a couple of the hitting partners now. Tell us how you got this gig to start.
So the guy who kind of runs Arangi Park, Peter Finn, he was looking to put together the team, and then I think Mike, you did it last year, and then I knew a few of the guys that did it last year, and he'd asked one of my friends, and I kind of put my name in the hat. I was like, Peter, like, I'd love to do that. That'd be a really cool job, because it's about as good as a job you can get at Wimbledon, isn't it? And yeah, he said, great, come on down and help us out.
Okay, so how many years have you been here? And then tell us just generally, what does the job entail?
So this is my second year. Yeah. So last year and this year, we're in around 9:30. We could do anything from match warm-ups to hour sessions if it's their day off. We'll do 4 or 5 hours a day, and it generally quietens down nearer the kind of start of the second week. But we'll be hitting with men, women, doubles, whatever goes. And each session is different. Some players look for more rhythm. Doubles guys obviously tend to do a lot of stuff at the net. I'm a lefty, so generally they look
You're
for the serve.
Baby.
Yeah, they look for the serve. So yeah, just depends really.
And you're both obviously experienced college players. Tell us about your tennis backgrounds.
So I played a lot here. So you know, probably a decent junior, made finals of nationals and stuff.
Okay, that's pretty decent.
And then I went to university 2 years ago. Just finished my second year in college. And I'm trying to use kind of college as a path to play professionally, hopefully somewhere near this level,
this
level.
And you just finished up at university, right?
Yeah, I just graduated May time. Similar to James, I'd love to play professionally, but if I can't do that, then I'd also love to travel with a pro as a hitting partner, more of a full-time basis. So I had a few offers when I was in college last year, but unfortunately I couldn't take them just because I still wanted to get my degree.
Okay, so tell us about nerves. If you go out across the net from one of the best players in the world, how are the nerves and how do you bring out your best tennis?
I think, if generally speaking, that most of the players are pretty nice.
Yeah.
So that definitely helps. Because if like, you walk on the court and they're pretty nice to you and you kind of realize they're just people and it's just a tennis ball.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's still hard. Like, it's not just a tennis ball because of who's hitting it. But, I mean, it's fun. Like, at the end of the day, like, if you don't do a good job, no one's going to die. Like, it's just some tennis.
Yeah.
So it's just playing tennis, and it's fun to go and just embrace the moment and enjoy the experience of playing with someone that good and that kind of stature. So.
You simplify it there, right, to calm the nerves, but also players are going to ask for specific things. You were kind of mentioning that. So tell us the different things that might happen in a practice, and there's the difference, right, between a pre-match warm-up and a real off day, a practice where they're out there, they're working on specific drills.
Yeah, I mean, The match warm-ups are very basic. You know, you'll hit down the middle for 5-10 minutes. They'll come and hit some volleys, smashes. And then again, being a lefty, it's just all about the serve. They just want to return a lot. Very basic stuff. Often it's scheduled for half an hour, but we're only on court for 20 minutes.
Sure.
Everyone's different. And then the day off is, they normally get an hour. And it will just be whatever they feel they want to do in regards to tactics against the player they're playing. So for example, you know, it could be I hit a forehand hard into their backhand and they've got to try and defend for the point. It just completely depends on who the player is and also who they play. So but like James was saying, it's an honor playing with them. And I think in regards to the nerves go away after 20 minutes, but then at the same time they have a lot on the line. This is their job, you know. So if you're warming someone up for, say, they've gone deep in a tournament, they haven't done well before, it's tough because we know how much it means to them, and you know, we don't want to be the person that's practiced with them and then they go and lose. So we try to do the best possible job we can to give them the best chance of winning.
Well, and it's an interesting one too, because you guys would hit with a variety of different players throughout the day, but then Mike, are you following results to see how your players have done?
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't. But last year I did a lot. I practiced with Isner a lot, and he had a really good tournament. So I think you like James was saying, if they're nice, you want them to do well. You know, you do. You really want them to do well, because you feel like you've helped them, so to speak, when they win. But I do follow it.
Yeah. And James, you obviously, there's the aspirations to play professionally yourself, but this is not a bad gig, I think, probably for the little kid who grew up watching Wimbledon yourself, right?
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's it's kind of surreal. Like every day I'm like text my mum, like, oh my God, I'm like hitting with Djokovic today. Like, yeah. Wow. But then, yeah, it's a really fun job and it's just great to be here. It's a nice place to just be as well, even if we weren't playing. So it's just brilliant, really.
You mentioned Djokovic. Give us a few other names of who you've hit with so far this fortnight.
So I've hit with Gasquet, Khachanov, Halep. I hit with Steve Johnson yesterday, the Bryan brothers, Jamie Murray. So, I mean, everyone uses the hitters.
And you?
Yeah, similar. So Muguruza, Halep, Cilic. Muguruza quite a few times before she lost. but yeah, Halep yesterday, I warmed her up for a match. Just a variety, really. Yeah. And it's quite tough because sometimes you can go from play having an hour with the male player and then a female, and the type of ball that you get is very different. So you have to adapt very quickly.
And last year, who were you following closely through the tournament?
I practiced with Isner a lot. So I was following him a lot. But then I also practiced with Osaka a lot. So anyone that you practice with that's generally, you know, nice to you, the coach is nice, you know, they told you you'd done a good job, you tend to follow their results.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's an amazing job, you guys, an amazing couple weeks here for you. What's your favorite part of Wimbledon? Because I think everyone watches at home, they see center court, but we're over here in Arangi, there's so much else to the championships.
I think my favorite part is everyone's just nice. Like, you hit with players and you kind of expect them to be like superstars, like, but they're just nice people, and it's nice to kind of see everyone who's so kind of like famous and big time, that they're just nice people and pretty down to earth when you just talk to them. It's just tennis and they're just people playing, so they just love playing tennis.
Yeah, no, it's everyone's super nice, and at the end of the day they're no different to you and I. They're just doing a job.
They're trying to tennis.
I mean, yeah, okay, they are very good at tennis. That's the big difference. But yeah, no, they're just doing a job, and they're just like any other athlete. They just want to win.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they, you know, the majority of them really appreciate what we do, and I think that's nice as coming off court, knowing that you've done a good job. So
yeah, awesome. Well, you guys, thanks so much, and it's good to hear the nerves aren't there for the practice sessions, but really cool, and enjoy your experience here at Wimbledon.
Cheers, thanks a lot.